Welcome to a lesson on the amplitude and period of the sine and cosine functions. This is a series of three videos. The next video we'll take a look at horizontal and vertical translations, and then in the third we'll combine all four transformations in one. So the goals of this video are to determine the period of a function, and then also to determine the amplitude of the sine and cosine wave. A function f is said to be periodic if f of x is equal to f of x plus np for all values of x. So if these two functions are equal, then the least possible constant p is called the period, and the period is required to be positive. A function with period p will repeat on intervals of length p. So if you take a look at this function here, if we start here when x is equal to 0, and then we go over to x equals 5, this is one complete cycle of the function, because after 5 it starts to repeat itself. Again, the period is the horizontal distance needed before the values begin to repeat. So if we look at the basic sine function, we can see that after the horizontal distance 2 pi, the function starts to repeat itself. Therefore, the period is equal to 2 pi for sine theta. And if we take a look at cosine theta, the same thing occurs. After a horizontal distance of 2 pi, the function would start to repeat itself again. So the period of the basic sine and cosine function is equal to 2 pi. However, if we take a look at the graphs of y equals sine of bx or y equals cosine bx, the period will change based upon the value of b. And in fact, the period will be either 360 degrees divided by b or 2 pi divided by b, based upon whether we're graphing in degrees or radians. Changing b results in what is called a horizontal dilation, which can also be called a horizontal stretch or compression. So if we want to determine the period of y equals cosine 3x, in radians we would take 2 pi and divide by the value of b, which is 3. This is our period in radians. If we wanted it in degrees, we could take 360 degrees, divide by 3, which is 120 degrees. And of course, 3 pi radians is equal to 120 degrees. For y equals sine x divided by 4, you might want to think of this as 1x over 4. So the value of b is actually 1/4. 2 pi divided by 1/4, remember, is the same as 2 pi times the reciprocal. So times 4 over 1, or just 4, which is equal to 8 pi. And this is equivalent to 1,440 degrees. The amplitude of a periodic function measures its height. The amplitude is defined as the farthest distance the wave reaches from the center of the wave. You can also think of the amplitude as half the vertical distance from the maximum and minimum values. So let's take a look at a couple graphs here. Here we see the graph of y equals sine x. This is the center of the wave, and you can see from the center to this maximum is equal to 1 unit, therefore the amplitude is equal to 1. But if we look at the next graph, y equals 3 sine x, take a look at the center of the wave again. From the center to the maximum is 3 units, as well as from the center to the minimum, so the amplitude is now 3. Again, you can think of the amplitude as half the distance from the max to the min. The distance from negative 3 to 3 is 6 units. Half of 6, of course, is 3. And lastly, we have y equals negative 2 sine x. Again, the distance from the center to the max or the min is equal to 2 units here. Therefore, the amplitude is equal to 2. And amplitude always has to be positive, so we do not want to include this negative here. Remember, this negative has the effect of a reflection across the x-axis. Okay, so in general, if we have the graph of y equals a sine x or y equals a cosine x, the amplitude is the absolute value of a. Remember, it always has to be positive. And the range of the function will be from negative absolute value of a to a on the closed interval. Changing a results in what is called a vertical dilation, which can also be thought of as a vertical stretch or compression. Okay, let's put both of these ideas together by stating the amplitude, period, and then graphing the function. So we have y equals sine of x divided by 3. So from this we can gather that a is equal to 1, and b would be equal to, remember there's a 1 here, so 1/3. Since a is equal to 1, or amplitude is equal to 1, the period is 2 pi divided by b. Since b is 1 third, 2 pi divided by 1 third is the same as 2 pi times 3 over 1, or 6 pi. So the next step is we mark off one period on our graph on our x-axis from 0 to 6 pi. Then we'll divide this interval into four equal parts. So half of 6 pi would be 3 pi. And then dividing it in half again, we'd have 3 pi over 2, and then here we would have 9 pi over 2. Now before we begin, let's review the basic sine function here. This also has an amplitude of 1, but the period has changed for the given function. But that's really the only difference. Notice we were to take this function and divide it into fourths. Notice if we were to take this period and divide it into fourths, the first fourth would be our maximum. The second fourth would be back to 0, the third fourth would be at negative 1, and the fourth fourth would be back at 0 for one complete cycle of the sine function. So the only difference here is now our period is 6 pi, so we're going to start at 0, then at 3 pi over 2 we'll be up at 1 since our amplitude is still 1. At 3 pi we'll be back at 0, 9 pi over 2 will be down at negative 1, and then at 6 pi we'll be back at 1. And now we can make a nice graph of y equals sine of x divided by 3. Notice the graphs look very similar. The only difference is we have a different period. Now let's graph y equals 1/2 cosine 2x. Notice for reference we'll use the basic graph of y equals cosine theta. Okay, so from this we can gather that a is equal to 1/2, b is equal to 2. Since a is 1/2, our amplitude is equal to 1/2, and our period is equal to 2 pi divided by b, so we have a period of pi radians. First step would be to mark off pi radians on the x-axis, divide it into four equal parts. So here's our pi, then we have pi over 2, this would be pi over 4, and this would be 3 pi over 4. Again, notice that for 0 radians, the basic cosine function is equal to positive 1. Well, if our amplitude is now only 1/2, at 0 radians the function value will be 1/2 rather than 1. And now the pattern will be consistent. At the next fourth we'll be down at 0. At the next fourth we'll be down at negative 1, but in this case negative 1/2, back to 0, and then back up to 1/2. These points are enough to make a nice graph of y equals 1/2 cosine 2x. Now notice that these functions look almost the same, but what we've changed is how we scaled the x-axis and how we scaled the y-axis. Let's go ahead and try one more. Now we have y equals negative 2 sine 3x. Notice again for reference we have y equals sine theta. This should help us see the pattern for the new graph. Remember, the amplitude is equal to the absolute value, so it's equal to 2. And the period is equal to 2 pi divided by b, so our period is 2 pi divided by 3. So we'll start by marking off our x-axis at 2 pi over 3. So here we have 0, 2 pi over 3 here. We'll divide this interval into four equal parts. So in the middle we have pi over 3. Half of that would be pi over 6. And half the distance between pi over 3 and 2 pi over 3 would be pi over 2. Okay, remember that at 0 radians, the basic sine function is equal to 0, so that'll still be true here. But now on the basic sine function, the first fourth, we're up at positive 1. Since the amplitude is 2, we might think we're going to be up at positive 2, but remember that this negative here results in a reflection across the x-axis, so we're actually down at negative 2. So you do have to be careful. When a is negative, you do have to reflect your function values across the x-axis. The second fourth would be back at 0. Notice on the third fourth, we're down at a minimum, but since we're reflecting across the x-axis here, we'll be at a maximum. In this case, since the amplitude is 2, we'll be up at 2, and then back to 0. So now we have enough points to make a nice graph of y equals negative 2 sine 3x. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching and have a good day.